Hello. Yes, now after having discussed the organs of speech and explaining the chart of the English consonants, now we shall discuss the consonant sounds, all the 24 consonant sounds individually. Okay? Or we may do one thing, instead of discussing all the sounds individually, we may discuss them in pairs. Like the first eight sounds are in pairs, so we may discuss them in pairs. And say eight, there are eight pairs as I told you, and there are eight single sounds. So we are discussing them in pairs. So let me take pa and ba first. Okay. This is how I'm writing. These two sounds I'm taking. I'm writing it there. Listen, I begin with this. Be very attentive. There are two sounds. Here I am writing them individually, but I am taking the pair. So, as far as three term description is concerned, please note. What do we write in three term description? We write that I'm talking pa and ba. First, pa. Pa, 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 pa. Pa is a bilabial plosive. Bilabial, voiceless plosive. Okay? What is it? It's a bilabial, voiceless plosive or stop. And this is ba, is a voiced, bilabial, voiced plosive. A stop, you may say. This is the term description. This is over. This is complete. There shouldn't be any confusion. Very easy it is. You know the chart. Remember the chart. Okay, how to make it. Remember the, say, locations of the sounds. And then just go on describing the three term description. Okay. So we begin with pa sound. Pa. While we were discussing vowels and diphthongs, we were talking about initial, medial, and final occurrence of the consonants. I'll say those sounds. Now, here also, let us talk about initial and final. Initial, medial, and final. Let us see. Since you know, I told you that I'll be discussing in pairs, so let me write initial, medial, and final here too. Okay? So here we shall write words starting with ba sound, and here we shall write words starting with pa sound. So for example, let us say the word pa, pin. In English, you write like this, pin, or say pet, and this is how you write in, say, phonetically also. Pa, e, and pin, and then pet, pa, e, and ta, pet. Okay? And here you write bin. Bin, you transcribe it like this, bin, and then you write bet here, bet is transcribed this way. Is it okay?
Yes.
So medially, where do you have here? Say, yeah. Let me know about
happy.
Happy, yeah, very good. Happy we may have. And you know, a similar sounding word can be shabby here. Shabby. Okay. Okay. This is how. And how do we transcribe? We transcribe happy like this. Happy. This is how you transcribe happy. And this is how you sh sound. And then a, this vowel. Then b. I'm sorry, what have I written here? Happy. Chevy. It's fine?
Yes, sir.
So we are taking two initial sound, one middle sound, and let us take final sounds now. Say cup. Cup. pa is occurring at the end.
Yes, sir.
And here you may have cup for that matter. Cup. Ba sound is coming here. The cup, how do you transcribe? You transcribe it like this. Cup. Cup. So easy. And this is how you already know transcription now. And we have like transcribed so many words. Cup. One more word. Come on. Like yes, pa sound in the end.
Sip.
Sip. Good. Sip. 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 This is very simple. Sip. The same way you transcribe it. Sip. There is no change. Okay. Yes. And here you may have then nib. In fact, you know that would have been better if you had given nip. Nip. Nip there. Well, it hardly matters. Nip, are you right? Nip and then nib. Because there is a change there in the final sound. You know, like for us, it's not difficult to differentiate between the two sounds. Nip, you write like this. Okay? Nip. Is that fine?
Yes.
You know, I was saying that it is not difficult for us, is the Indians, I mean, to differentiate between the two sounds, pa and ba. Pa, ba. They are very dissimilar sounds for us. But you know, Arabians, you know, because some Arabian friends studied with me, so like, they won't call it pani. Okay, what do they say? They say bani. In the Arabic, you do not have pa. In Urdu, you have pa, but you do not have this pa in Arabic. You have alif, ba, ta, sa. Alif, ba, ta, sa. But in Urdu, you have alif, ba, pa, ta, sa. So there is no pa there in Arabic. That's why, you know, they wouldn't say pani, they would say bani. You know, it's really very interesting, you know, if students from different countries are there with you. So this, this phonetics, you know, this becomes all the more interesting, and it becomes very challenging too for the teacher, because you know he keeps asking say ba, say ba, say pa, pa, and it's very difficult for them, and this is equally difficult for us as well. Yes, you know, they are Indian languages. Where you have more than say 40-45 letters in the alphabet, so if you like, you won't be able to, because you do not have so many there in your alphabet. So it's difficult, it becomes very challenging to pronounce words with unheard letters of alphabet. It was very while I was staying in Kerala, Trivandrum, it was very difficult for me to like speak their language. But gradually I picked up many phrases and all, and I could communicate with them.